Are you looking for a stretching and mobility routine that you can do every day for your neck, shoulders, arms, hips, and back? Well, I got it, and I'll show you in this video. In this video, I'm going to give you 13 exercises, stretching and mobility exercises that you can do at home in the morning, in the evening, or afternoon to help keep mobile and flexible your neck, shoulders, hips, and back. Follow me on this.
And remember to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell.
Dr. Walter Salubro, chiropractor in Vaughan, Ontario, Canada. And just the other day, I did a live video on Facebook. And in this video here, you're gonna get the stretching mobility routine. And you're gonna see a bunch of stretches, not just for your neck and shoulders, but also for your wrists and also for your hips and lower back. You'll find this very useful in stretching out and loosening those kinks and tensions that you may feel either in your neck and shoulders or hips and low back. And part of this routine is not just stretching, but also mobility. So give this a try, let me know what you think, and let's get started right now. Awesome. So we're gonna start in a few more minutes and a few more seconds, and I want you to follow along, do the best you can. These are similar exercises that I give to my current patients as well. So if you're a practice member or patient of mine, then these will be a review. Be sure you're doing your home exercises during this time. And if you're not a part of my practice right now, follow along anyways. So we're gonna get started, and we're gonna start standing, and then we'll get down on the floor. So you might need a yoga mat or a soft surface, like a carpet surface. So let's get going. We're gonna do a light warm up first. Just bring your knees up, just get your blood circulating, get your hips moving, right? Nice high knees like this. Get moving, that's it. Okay, now we're gonna move into some neck mobility, range of motion in a moment, but just get your body moving, get your blood circulating. If you've been stiff, it's a good thing to keep mobile and flexible, especially during stressful times. That's it. Keep it going, keep it going. Legs high, knees, just get moving like that. Any type of motion is good. All right, good, keep it going. Just gonna take this out over here. Get some more viewing, keep it going. All right, a few more. That's it. 10 more seconds. Nice. The blood circulating through your systems, your muscles. Good, awesome. So we're gonna start with the upper neck and shoulder routine. First thing I want to do is the range of motion. So some of these I'll be facing you, some of these I'll be to the side. So we'll start with the side. So basically I want you to bring your head back and forward. Watch your balance. Do it at least 10 times. Get a full range of motion. So it's flexion and extension. And one more. Good. Now we're going to do lateral side bending, full range of motion, ear to shoulder. Ear to shoulder, full range of motion. That's it, keep it going. Do 10 of these as well. Get those joints moving, muscles stretch at the same time. Let's do 5 more. Good, full range. That's it, keep it going. 2 more. Slow and rhythmic. And last one. Let's get an extra one in there. Good. Right on. Now we're going to do rotations. Full range of motion. Chin to shoulder as far as you can. Within your tolerance. If there's pain or degeneration, within your tolerance. With full range of motion. That's 2. Right on. 3. Nice fluid motions. 4, full rotations. If you're only going halfway, not to worry about it. Just pay attention to that. That's something that needs to be worked on. Following the motion as far as you can. Feel those muscles stretching. So what we've done is we've done range of motion in all the physiological motions of the spine in your neck. Let's do three more. Good. Two. One. Right on. How you guys doing so far? Let me know in the comments later on. Right on. So next we're going to do our arm circles. So again, just get those shoulder joints moving. Nice big arm circles. I remember when I was in high school in grade 9, I used to go to school in Toronto, Bellisle College, and our gym teacher, if we had an hour and 15 minutes of classes, I swear that half of it was just doing arm circles. We all want to play sports and games, but half of it was just warm-ups and arm circles. So they're very good for you. Keep your shoulders mobile. Nice big circles, big wide ones. Go back as far as you can. Big wide ones, good. That's backwards. And if you've done backwards, now go forward. If you've done forward, go backwards. That's it. Big wide circles. Feel that stretch in your shoulder muscles. You should feel your muscles achy right about now. At least I do. Get narrow ones in there. Good. Keep it going. Keep it going. So did the neck. Do your shoulders. All right. Two. One. Nice. One more for bonus. All right. Now, I'm going to add one that's not on my list. It's shoulder rolls. So I just go to the side like this and basically just turn the shoulders back. Nice and loose. Not stiff. Nice loose shoulder rolls. Just like that. So it gets all your upper trap and upper back muscles moving as well as your shoulders and scapula, which is your shoulder blade. So do 10 going backwards. Good. Four. Three, two, one. Now 10 going forwards. Forward. It's not an arm motion, elbow motion, it's a shoulder. Get your shoulders moving. Muscles loose. That's it. Way to go. Keep it going. Keep it going. Four, five, four, three, two, and one. Nice. How's your shoulders and neck feeling so far? We have some comments. Hey, Dr. Ryan, awesome. Glad to have you on. All right, so let's do some neck stretches now. Neck stretches. Again, be cautious. If you have a neck problem, do it within your tolerance. Take your hand on your head and pull it over to the side like this. You have a nice stretch through your neck and upper shoulders right there. So we give this to our patients often. So it's a good review if you're one of my patients, and you pull ear to shoulder. Sometimes I'll say bring your other arm, put it behind your back, and you're going to do a counter pull. So this pulls this way, this pulls down, a counter pull. There you go. With stretches, I want you to hold them for 10 seconds, then you release and do them three times. So we're going to do two more times. I like the counter pull version. If it's too hard for you, put your hand over here. That's it. 10 second hold. And release. I feel a nice stretch in my neck muscles. One more time on the same side. Good thing to do these in the morning. About 10, 15 minutes after you wake up. Grab some water and get your joints and muscles moving before your day starts. Good. Now, other side. You may feel one side tighter than the other. That happens sometimes. Good. 10 second hold. So if one side is tighter than the other, then you work out that side a bit more. Good. And release. Two more times. So you want to hold for 10 seconds, a full 10 second stretch, hold stretch. And then you need to give it time to recover after that. That's it. Feels really good. One more, then we're going to do a variation of this. I like the hand behind the back. You don't have to. You can put it here. Stretch. Counter pull. All right. guys. Feeling good. Awesome. Good. We're going to move to another next stretch. And I plan to do more of these live workout sessions. So I'd like to know from you what kind of things you want to see. And also be sure to, if you're following our page, be sure to click on see first when you're following us like this. You don't miss out on the notifications, right? So a variation of the neck stretch is an angled neck stretch. So very similar. You're going to turn your head to one side, look down to your toe, and pull on the angle like this. It targets another set of muscles back here. Very good stretch. 10-second hold. Release. And I always prefer to do the same side. So three on the same side and then switch. Don't alternate. 10-second hold. Feels really good to stretch, by the way. And release. And again. Feels great. Feel tension releasing in my neck and shoulders. Great. And then to the other side. So turn, turn, look down to your toe, and then pull. 10-second hold. Good. Two more times. Two more times. Turn, down. So we finish the upper neck, the neck and upper back shoulder stretches. We'll move down to the ground and do some low back mobility stretches as well. One more. Turn down. I feel a stretch right up to my upper shoulder blade area. Good. Many times neck referral patterns will go to the upper back of the head over here. And the upper back over here. And those are usually referral patterns that come from the neck joints. So working out the neck joints is very helpful to help with that. Okay, next one is shoulder and back stretches. So what we're gonna do is then turn to the side like this, clasp your hands, and you're gonna go like this. And the motion is that you want to pull your arms out away from your body and stretch the middle back. So pretend there's a rope pulling you in that direction attached to your arms. In your hands, just like that. Good. Three times. Give that a good 10 second hold. Very good. Okay. And again, stretch the middle back area and shoulders. Pull forward. Good. And one more. Right there, get a good stretch. And with each stretch, with each repetition, you should feel your flexibility get better and better, your length get better and better, which is what I noticed on my third one. Oh, good. Now, variation of that, we're gonna go upwards. Let me back up a bit, clasp your hands, up, and pretend that your hands are being pulled to the ceiling. Up, 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 just like that. There you go. Oh, it feels so good. If you're enjoying this, let me know in the comments when we're done. Oh, yes. Two more. Clasp your hands. Stretch that upper back area and the shoulders. Pull to the ceiling. I'm going to do one more. Stretch for the upper area, then move down to the mat for the lower back too. Good. One more stretch. Feels really good, by the way. Hope you're following along. Let me know how you're feeling and how you're doing after we're done. Oh, get a nice stretch. Really pull up to the ceiling. Right up there. Good. If you bring your head up, even better. Get some extension into your neck, the cervical curve. Great. Awesome. Shake that off. Okay, next one we're going to do is a wrist stretch. So be very careful if you have a wrist problem. Be careful with this, but basically take your wrist, arm straight, and just stretch it out like this. That's it. Good. We're going to do three times here. Back and front on both sides. Good. Shake it off. Again, pull your hand towards you. Get a stretch through these muscles over here. Good. One more. That's it. Way to go.
If you type all day, if you're a tradesperson, you know how to use hand tools, if you're writing, whatever it is that we use our hands and fingers all the time, these muscles get tight. It's a good stretch for that muscle there. And then we're going to stretch this one as well too. So palm up, elbow straight, and you're going to stretch out your hands. Pull from the palm of your hands, not your fingers. There you go. 10-second hold. You might find that these are tight for you, which means they need to be worked on regularly. Release, and again. That's it. Feels really good, but actually. And one more. That's it. Very good. Very good. You're going to switch arms. Great. So let me turn this side so you can see. So palm down and turn in. Then we'll move down to the floor and do the lower back mobility and stretches. Release. Feels really good right now, my forearm muscles right in here. And again, be sure to hold the stretch for 10 seconds. It gives it a chance for the tight muscles to fatigue as you're stretching and making them longer. And then the rest part is very good. You want to rest as well in between your stretch to give it a chance to recover. Good. Having fun so far? You enjoyed this? Let me know in the comments. Once you're done with the session, plan to do more of these. We've got to stay active and mobile. Great. Awesome. So that's part one. And hope you enjoyed that so far. Let's go to part two. I'm going to tilt my camera down and get on the yoga mat. And we're going to do some mobility exercises and then some stretches. Make sure the mat is visible. Okay, good. All right, so if you have a carpet, a yoga mat, a towel, anything you might want to put on the ground. It's not necessary, but it might make it a bit more comfortable. Okay, so let's start with the classic mad cat mobility. So hands and knees, nice and square, okay? Square, and you're going to head down, round the back like this, and then drop it down and arch it and look up. I'm just looking at the screen to make sure that I'm captured on the screen for you. So up, we're going to do 10 of these. So that's one, round. So this is a stretch and a mobility. It's a low back pelvic mobility exercise plus a good stretch for the middle back area as well. That's two. Three, get some fluid motion into it. Get some rhythmic motion. Four. Five. Six. Seven. That's it. Keep it going. Eight. Nine. And 10. Great. Awesome. Now, let's do some hip mobility movements. So you get on the ground. We're going to do three versions of these on both sides, both hips. So get yourself comfortable on the floor. See, you see me there? That's good. Okay. So first of all, you bring your hips up just like that. Do 10 of these. You can always do more later on. So it's three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Get those hips moving. Unlock those hips. And one more, 10. Then turn to your side. Then you do 10 lateral. Bend the bottom knee to support you. This one straight up like this. 10 of those. 10, three, four. Be sure you're not going up like that. That's not good. You want to go lateral, five, Not only is it a hip mobility exercise, but it's also gluteus medius strengthening exercise. Very good as well. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Great. Then you get on your tummy and you do the same side backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Awesome. We have two hips, so we do both sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Onto your side. Bend the bottom knee. Get comfortable. Leg straight. Up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Great. On your tummy again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Great. And if you found 10 to be too easy repetitions, then go to 20 and eventually 30. Okay, let's get some stretches done. So this mobility, let's get some stretches done. On your back, hamstring stretches. Okay, take your leg, knee straight, and pull. Now you see my legs are tight. I need to work on these more. So pull, knee straight. 10-second hold. You want to be up to 90 degrees. Good. 3 times. Very good. Hold that for 10 seconds. Pull below your knee, not at your knee. If you can't reach, you grab a towel, put a towel, hook it up against your thigh, and pull the towel. Nice stretch in there. By stretching your thigh muscles, your quads, and your hamstrings helps your pelvis and lower back area as well. Because they connect to your sacrum muscles, which connects to your spine, to your ligaments. Very good. 10-second hold. Then we're going to switch. And I got some work to do as well. Okay, good. And switch. So I have a bit more flexibility on my left one. You may notice that as well. Okay, pull. 10-second hold. 10-second hold. Get a nice stretch in your hamstring muscles. Feels really good, by the way. Good. 2 more times. Give it a break. Very good. Keep it going. You may notice you're going to be a bit more flexible with the second and third repetition, so you go further into the stretch. Very, very important. Knee straight and pull. I feel a stretch from my knee right down to my glutes. Knee straight as much as possible. Good. Get a bit more stretching there. Oh yeah, feels great. Okay, what's next on the list? Hamstring stretches. So, get on your side, make yourself comfortable, grab your knee, and bend back. Okay, so stretch your core. Sorry, these are quad stretches. My mistake, I read the wrong line. Quadricep stretches. 10 seconds, 3 times each. And you can also be standing or lying down, whatever is easier for you. I like the standing one, but we're doing floor versions today in this routine. Hope you're enjoying this. If you are and you want to see more of these type of videos, please tell me in the comments below. Also tell me the type of content you want to see. If you want to see workshops or tutorials, the topics you like, any particular conditions, or just simply stretches and exercises. We got time on our hands with this situation going on right now. that I can produce this content for you. So let's do that. Two more. Keep it going. Keep it going. Release. One more time, then we're going to switch. Feels really good, by the way. Okay, good. Now we're going to switch sides. Go this way so you can see me. That's it. Be sure to get some water after this. Don't know about you, but because of the movements, I'm working up a sweat already. So stay hydrated. Very, very important. Release. Hook your foot. 10-second hold. Do two more times. Good. One more. Right on. We're almost done. We have a few more stretches for the back and the hip and the gluteus area. I think that was three. Right on. Shake it off. Okay. Back onto your back. Let me go this way so I have more space for you. We're going to knee to chest stretches. Stretch the glute muscles, lower back. Gently lie down. One at a time, pull towards your body. So I give these often to our patients. 10-second hold. Straight knee to chest. Knee to chest. Hold for 10 seconds. Hook with your hands. If you can't reach, grab a towel, put it behind your thigh, and hook behind your thigh. If you have knee problems, knee replacements, you can hook behind your thigh as well. So you can still do this. Give this to a lot of my patients. Relax. Two more times. Feel a stretch from all the way through here. Hold that for 10 seconds. As always, stretch as you hold it for 10 seconds. And with each repetition, you should be able to feel yourself going closer and closer to your body, getting more stretch. Like this. Perfect. Once we do this, we're going to switch to the other side. 10 seconds hold. Get a good pull and release. Great. Switch to the other side. Now, for me, my right side is tighter than my left. You may find that as well. So that needs more work. I can get my knee closer to my chest. So you still work out both sides, but you do extra on the other one. On a tighter one. 10 seconds, release. And again. Good. Keep it going. Keep it going. One more. Then we're going to do a variation of this. Right there. Good. Feels good. So keeping the hips mobile first really helped. Getting your body warmed up first really helped to get more flexibility. Right on. Now, variation. Knee to chest, but pull the opposite shoulder. So angle. I'll use one hand so you can see. Angle. Don't do too much twisting. It's just a hip and lower back glute stretch. Angle. Knee to opposite shoulder. 10-second hold. Repeat three times. Very good. Two more. Over, opposite shoulder. So you see I'm on an angle with this. That way. Very good. Keep it going. Keep it going. Good. One more. Great. Two sides. Do the other one. Pull. Opposite shoulder. If you want to open up your shoulder, you can take this arm and put it on like this as well. Do a combination move. Very good stretch. Gluteus, lower back. Lateral side of your mid back as well. Pull. Over. That's it. Nice, good stretch. Pull towards your shoulder. Feel that muscle tension releasing. make you a little achy as well. That's okay. There's such thing as good aches and pains when you're working out. And one more. Okay, good. Nice, good stretch. My arm is still up here as well. Nice. Now we're going to do another variation of this. Double knee stretch. Grab your knees, pull to your body. Hold 10 seconds. Release. Three times total. Pull both knees. If you have trouble reaching your knees, grab a towel, pull from underneath. Same idea as before. Very good. One more on this set, then we got one more stretch, and we're going to wrap this up. Hope you're enjoying this. I know I am, and I'd love to do this again. If you like it, let me know. Comment below. Like it. Share this with your family and friends. They probably need this too. And let me know what you like, and I'll do more. Right on. Good. Next one is going to be, and is the last one, is a piriformis stretch. A little tricky. So take your knee, bend it, foot on the ground. Take this one, figure four position. Grab the bent knee and pull towards your body. You get a nice stretch through here and through the piriformis. That's it. Very good. Hold 10 seconds. Now, if your knee is out to here, you know you have a tight piriformis. It should be way more opened up. Now, I have some work to do with this as well. You can feel that tightness in there. There we go. Good, 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 good. 10-second hold. That's it. And release. And you can just let it rest like this. And pull. So make sure if you're stuck indoors, which you probably are, that you do some kind of mobility stretching. Any kind of exercise is better than nothing. Hold, 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 hold. Release. One more time. That's it. Good stretch. Very important. Then we're going to switch sides. Okay, great. So, hook this one up, figure four on this one, inside here, and pull back. That's it. Hold that stretch, 10 seconds. Hold, hold, hold. Two more times. Pull. Very good. So you're using this side as a lever to stretch the opposite side. And one more. Over, over, over. Great. That's a wrap. All right.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed that, and I want to hear from you. What was your favorite stretch or mobility? Was it the neck stretch or mobility exercise, or was it the mad cow for the low back or even the hamstring stretch? Let me know in the comments below, and if you enjoyed this, pass it on with a friend or family member by sharing it, or also like to let me know that you liked it, and leave a comment below as well what you liked about it. And of course, remember to subscribe to this video so you don't miss out on new videos that I put on a regular basis. Subscribe to this channel and also tap on the notification bell. This is Dr. Walter Salubro, and I'll catch you on the next video.
To learn more about how corrective chiropractic care at Back to Health Chiropractic Center can help you with your chronic pain problem, visit www.ibthcc.com. Back to Health Chiropractic Center is located at 20 Cranston Park Avenue, number 6, Vaughan, Ontario, L6A 2W2.